A very good morning to all of you. I am Poonam Bagga and we are studying Chapter 3, Understanding Quadrilaterals. In our previous class, we had started exercise 3.3 based on the properties of a parallelogram. We had done first 6 questions of it and today we will be continuing the same exercise and start with question number 7 of exercise 3.3. Here it is. The adjacent figure HOPE, you can see this figure HOPE, is a parallelogram. Find the angle measures X, Y and Z. State the properties you use to find them. Now, first of all, let us name this point, this particular point, let us name it as R. Now, it will be easy to name the angles. First of all, I would like to draw your attention towards these two sides, EH and PO. Let me change the color of the pen. Now, these two sides are parallel to each other and this side HOR is a transversal here. So, what are these two angles forming? How are these two angles related? Just have a look and then you can identify that these two angles, angle EHO and angle POR, these two angles are forming a pair of corresponding angles and so they will be equal. So, we start with finding the value of Z first. Let me first erase this. Now, we start writing. We will take up the first point. We have EH parallel to PO. Therefore, angle EHO is equal to angle POR. The reason is corresponding angles. Now, angle EOH is a combination of two angles, this one of 40 degree and the other one named Z. So, we can easily write 40 degree plus Z. This is angle EHO. This is equal to this angle POR of measure 70 degree. So, equal to 70 degree. This gives us Z equal to 70 degree minus 40 degree and then Z is equal to 30 degree. This is the first value that we have found. Then second point. Now again these two sides are parallel, EH and PO, and you can see this is the transversal PH. So angle Y and this angle of 40 degree measure, these two angles are the alternate interior angles. I am talking about this angle, this one, and then this angle Y. These two angles are the alternate interior angles when we have this side parallel to PO. Clear to you? And we know that the alternate interior angles are equal in measure. So, we write here again EH is parallel to PO. Then angle EHP, this is equal to angle HPO. Angle EHP, this particular angle is equal to angle HPO, this one. The reason is alternate interior angles. Let us write here alternate interior angles. Then this EHP is 40 degree in measurement and this is equal to Y. So, this gives us the second value of Y. Now, we have this Y equal to 40 degree and this Z equal to 30 degree. What is left now? We have to find the value of x. You can clearly see that this angle x and this complete angle, these two angles are the, let me mark them properly so that you can identify which two angles I am talking about. These two angles are the adjacent angles of this parallelogram, and so we will apply the property of the adjacent angles, which says that the sum of adjacent angles is 180 degree. Let us apply it. I am writing it here. Third part, we can say that angle E plus angle H on the whole we are taking is equal to 180 degree. Give the reason. Adjacent angles of a parallelogram are supplementary. Then we can write, let us put the values, angle E is x and angle H is 40 degree plus this Z is 30 degree. So, we can write 30 degree equal to 180 degree. This gives us x equal to 180 degree minus 70 degree, because 30 plus 40 is 70 degree, and this gives us equal to 110 degree, the value of x. So, we have x equal to 110 degree. In this way, we have found all the three unknown angles in this figure. Clear to you? We move on to question number 8. The following figures GUNS and RUNS, this is the second part which we will be taking in next slide. In this first slide, we are having this parallelogram GUNS. G, U, N and S. These are parallelograms. Find x and y given the lengths are in centimeters. Now, what are you seeing? Here, the sides have been given. The angles are missing now. So, now we will apply the property of the sides of a parallelogram instead of applying the property of angles. What is the property by which these sides are related to each other in case of a parallelogram? Yes, the opposite sides are equal. Let us apply it here. We write, since GUNS is a parallelogram, the opposite sides will be equal. This means that SN, this side SN is equal to GU. Okay, let us put in the values. SN is 26 and GU is 3y minus 1. What we have got is a linear equation in one variable. Now, we have to transpose this one to the LHS and then find the value of y. Clearly, this is minus 1 on the right hand side. When we take it to the LHS, it will become plus 1. This will give us 26 plus 1 equal to 3y, or we can say 3y is equal to 27. This gives us y equal to 27 upon 3, this is equal to 9. So, in this way, we have got y equal to 9. This is the first value out of the two that we have been asked. We have found y. Now, x is remaining. For this we will again equate these two sides, this side and this side. These two sides are equal. Let us write it. Again, this SG is equal to NU. SG is nothing but 3x and NU is equal to 18. This gives us x equal to 18 upon 3, which is equal to 6. In this way, we get the value of x equal to 6. So, the final answer is x equal to 6 and y equal to 9. These were the two values which were asked in this question. Clear you? Next, we have the second part of this same question. Here, we have been given a parallelogram RUNS and the lengths of the corresponding parts of each diagonal have been given. So, which property will be applied here in this case? Clearly, not the property of the angles and not the property of the sides, because the measures of sides and angles are missing in this figure. Then, we will be applying the property of the diagonals, which states that the diagonals bisect each other. That means they divide each other into two equal parts. Then, which diagonal should be taken up first? This one NR or SU? This is again one question. Let us first mark the point of intersection of the diagonals as O. Now, if we consider the diagonal NR first, then we will have to equate this NO and OR. But then we will be having two variables here, x and y, and we don't know the values of both x and y. So, it will be difficult to find out their values. Instead of taking NR first, if we take this diagonal SU first, then we have only a single variable y in this case, and then it will be easy to find out the value of y. Once we find out y, we will put its value in this case NO and OR, and then x can be found. Let us write whatever we have discussed in the given figure. We have SO equal to OU. Give the reason. The diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. This means they are equal in length. Then let us put in the value. SO is 20 and OU is y plus 7. Clearly, this 7 will be transposed to the LHS and become minus 7. This will give us y equal to 13. This is the value of y, the first result that we were required to find. Now, we come on to the second part. Again, the corresponding parts of this diagonal NR, we are talking about NO and OR, they will be equal. Again, NO is equal to OR. The same reason, diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. With this, let us put in the values. NO is x plus y and OR is equal to 16. Now, we put in the value of y here. Now, it is known to us, x plus 13 is equal to 16. This implies that x is equal to 16 minus 13, or we can say x is equal to 3. This is the value of x and this is the value of y. In this way, we have found both the values of x and y. Next, we have the question. In the given figure, both RISK and CLUE are parallelograms. Find the value of x. Here, we have to find this value of x right in the middle. Now, we are having two parallelograms, RISK and CLUE. To find x, let us now focus on these two angles, this particular angle and this one, angle CEU and angle ISK. If we find these two angles, then by applying the angle sum property of a triangle in this small triangle, let us name this point as M, in this triangle ESM, if we get the values of this angle E and S, then we can easily find angle x. So first of all, we will find angle CEU. We consider this parallelogram CLUE, and we are interested in this angle CEU. Now, can you relate this angle with this given angle of 70 degree? Yes, these two angles are the opposite angles of parallelogram CLUE, and the opposite angles are equal. So, we begin our work in the given figure or in the parallelogram CLUE. We have angle CEU equal to angle L equal to 70 degree. Why? Because the opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Okay, so with this we get angle CEU equal to 70 degree. This particular angle, this is equal to 70 degree. Now we are interested to find angle S, this one KSI. This angle KSI is a part of the parallelogram RISK, and this angle S is related to this angle of given measure 120 degree. In which way? How are these two angles related? Yes, these two angles are the adjacent angles of the parallelogram RISK. Clear to you? So now we can apply the property of the adjacent angles, which states that the adjacent angles are supplementary or their sum is equal to 180 degree. So let us write it in parallelogram RISK. The sum of angle K and angle KSI is equal to 180 degree. This one KSI. Why is it 180 degree? Because the adjacent angles of a parallelogram are supplementary. Now, angle K is given to be 120 degree and angle KSI has to be found. This is equal to 180 degree. This gives us angle KSI equal to 180 minus 120 equal to 60 degree. Angle KSI, this one, this is equal to 60 degree. Now consider this small triangle in between, triangle ESM. In triangle ESM, if we apply the property, angle sum property of a triangle, the sum of the three angles equal to 180 degree, then we can easily find out the value of x. So in triangle ESM, the sum of angle ESM plus angle M E S plus angle E M S is equal to 180 degree. We have taken each angle E S M, M E S and E M S. Okay. By angle sum property of a triangle. Now let us put in the values. Angle ESM is 60 degree measure, then we have MES which is of measure 70 degree, plus this is x equal to 180 degree. This gives us x equal to 180 minus 60 plus 70 is 130, so subtract 130, this gives us x equal to 50 degree. This is the final answer. We have got the value of x. Clear to you? Next we have question number 10. Explain how this figure is a trapezium, which of its two sides are parallel. Here we are having one quadrilateral KLMN and two of its angles have been given. Angle M is 100 degree and angle L is 80 degree. And we have to examine whether this is a trapezium or not. Let us recall the property of a trapezium. In it, one pair of opposite sides is parallel. Now, if in this figure, if we get a pair of opposite sides as parallel, then this will be a trapezium. We have been given these two angles and the sum of these two angles is clearly 180 degree. 100 plus 80 is 180 degree. And these angles are nothing but the co-interior angles, angles being formed on the same side of the transversal. Consider these two line segments, NM and KL. This is the transversal intersecting these two line segments and clearly these two angles are being formed on the left side, same side of the transversal ML. And since their sum is coming up to be 180 degree, this means that these two sides NM and KL will be parallel and then it will be a trapezium. Let us write it here. In the given figure, angle M plus angle L is equal to 100 degree plus 80 degree and this is equal to 180 degree. But these two angles are co-interior angles that means angles formed on the same side of the transversal. ML. This is transversal. This means that since the sum is coming up to be 180 degree, this means that the line segments NM is parallel to KL. These two line segments are parallel. Since one pair of opposite sides is coming up to be parallel, this means that KLMN is a trapezium and this was to be proved in this case. Okay, now we have question number 11. Find the measure of angle C in the given figure if this AB is parallel to DC. These two sides have been given parallel and we have to find the measure of angle C and this angle has been given. Now, how are these two angles, the one which is given and the one which has been asked, how are these two angles related to each other? Yes, they are again forming a pair of co-interior angles, angles formed on the same side of the transversal. So, we can say in the given figure, angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. We have been given AB parallel to DC. And since they are co-interior angles, this is the reason. Therefore, their sum is equal to 180 degree. This gives us 120 degree plus angle C equal to 180 degree. Then angle C equal to 180 degree minus 120 degree and this gives us angle C equal to 60 degree. This is the measure of angle C, 60 degree. Okay, next we have question number 12. Here we have to find the measure of angle P and S. This one angle P and this angle S. If SP is parallel to RQ, this SP is given parallel to RQ and we have to find more than one method of finding angle P. Again, these two sides are parallel. SP and RQ, these two sides are parallel, and this SR is the transversal. So, how are these two angles related to each other? Clearly, these two angles are again co-interior angles formed on the same side of the transversal. This small square represents the angle of 90 degree, and this S we have to find. So, first we will find out angle S in the given figure. We have angle S plus angle R equal to 180 degree. The reason is co-interior angles. Again, mention here that SP is parallel to RQ. That is why these two are supplementary. Now, angle S we have to find, and angle R has been given equal to 90 degree. Their sum is 180. This gives us angle S equal to 180 minus 90 is equal to 90 degree. So, angle S is equal to 90 degree. This first value we have got, which was asked. Then second part, also these two angles, angle P and angle Q, again these two angles are on the same side of the transversal, and so they are co-interior angles. So we can say again angle P plus angle Q is equal to 180 degree. Clearly the reason is co-interior angles. And then angle P will be equal to 180 minus measure of angle Q is 130. So, minus 130, this gives us angle P equal to 50 degree. This is the value of angle P. Again, we discuss the second method of how this angle P can be found. Clearly, we know this angle S is 90 degree, this is 90 and this is 130. So, here we can apply the angle sum property of a quadrilateral, which says that the sum of all the four angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree, and then we can find the value of P. Angle P plus angle Q plus angle R plus angle S is equal to 360 degree. Angle sum property of a quadrilateral. We have three measures, 130 plus 90 plus 90 equal to 360 degree. Add up the three angles, it comes up to be 310 degree equal to 360 degree. This gives us angle P equal to 360 degree minus 310. Subtract the two, we get angle P equal to 50 degree. So, again we are getting the same value, which is correct. In this way, we can find angle P by two different methods. So, this was your exercise 3.3 based on the properties of a parallelogram. In our next class, we will be taking up some special parallelograms. Till then, practice this exercise. Thank you.